Starter was already replaced on this Dodge Neon approximately a year ago, but that got an issue with starting again because I installed the used starter. Right now I ordered the new starter and I will be replacing it right now. As you can see, it skips and it takes a while to start, sometimes up to 15 seconds. At the first part of this video I explained how to replace the starter from the top, and since I'm doing all this labor right now and the vehicle is already jacked up and standing on the jacks, in the second part of the video I will explain how to replace the starter from the bottom. This is the starter, you can see him. Let's replace him from the bottom. First of all, disconnect the negative terminal of the battery. Well, from the bottom I found out that you only can access only this bolt, which belongs to the starter, and this electrical connector, which belongs to the starter as well. But besides it, nothing else. You still need to remove the throttle body hose from the top to get access to all electrical connectors and the remaining bolt which is on top of the starter. So let's proceed. Let's remove the throttle body hose by loosening this bolt. And this bolt. Using a large size flat screwdriver. As soon as you're done, you can get access to electrical connector, which is located right here. You also need to disconnect this vacuum hose. It'll give you some extra space. There is no enough space for the breaker or ratchet to loosen the upper bolt of the starter, because the whole box is preventing. That's why I remove it completely, which is pretty easy to do. Disconnect this connector, disconnect this hose, this connector. Remove this bolt from here. This electrical connector. And this is pretty much it. You will be able to this hose as well, but it will just come out by itself. This bolt from here. As soon as you partially remove the air cleaner box, you can see that you actually very easily can access this bolt the upper bolt of the starter, which is located right here, and make him loose. You don't need to disconnect the accelerator cable, just keep the box temporarily like this. Use the breaker, put the breaker in this case. Breaker couldn't fit properly, that's why I use this large size ratchet with 15mm socket. And as you can see, the upper bolt of the starter is loose. And then remove him with your fingers. This is the upper bolt, this is the ground point. Keep in mind that you have to plug it back. Very, very important. Locate it on the bolt itself, on the upper bolt of the starter. It's time to remove the lower bolt. Better to do it from underneath. Need some additional light. This one 15mm as well. Let's put a breaker on it. It's already loose. Make him loose enough and then remove him with your fingers. It's not that easy to completely remove the lower bolt because starter lost all support from the top. That's why temporarily put the upper bolt a little bit to support him. And then you will be able to remove the lower bolt. Just a little bit. It's supporting on top. Right now you really can remove the lower bolt. The lower bolt is out and time to remove the upper bolt. Starter is constantly pivots. But at least from the top you can hold him. I have the upper bolt is out as well. Both of those bolts are 15 millimeters and they are the same length. Put them away. And starter is out. You can right now remove the electrical connectors. This one and this one. You need to use a ratchet with 14 millimeter socket to remove this bolt from the starter. And this ground point, just simply tap on it right here and it will come out away from the starter. As soon as the electrical connectors, both of them are disconnected, this one and this one, you can remove the starter. Maybe it's better to remove him from the bottom. It will just drop. Here we go. Our starter is removed from the bottom. Just received the new starter. It's better always to install new instead of rebuild one. It will last you a lot longer because this one from the junker lasted me only 1 year. Time to install the new one. Before the new one will be installed, it's very, very important to compare the size and all electrical connectors. Yes, all of them match. Absolutely two identical starters. Let's install it. I think it will fit from the top. Or maybe not. Let's see. It's only, you only can squeeze him through the bottom and then little by little start inserting him and connecting electrical connectors. This connector will be the first one, then this one, the second connector is not that easy to connect, that's why I decided to insert the starter firstly and mount him with at least one bolt. Don't forget to put this ground point with this upper bolt. Goes actually through the bolt. And mounts the starter. And little by little, tighten him from the top. The ground point is in, as you can see, very important. Just a little bit to support him. Do not fully tighten it to specs, because you need as well to connect this electrical connector. It will be not that easy to squeeze through. Almost no space. Especially make sure that this one is aligned properly. This wire goes through. It's supposed to go through this hole. This is the proper alignment. And install it on an electrical connector. It's actually a pretty tough space. So what I did, I put the socket on it and I'm manually tightening it. Like this. With my hands, and then I will put a ratchet. Since this black wire was constantly moving when starter was in vertical position, right now connector is already installed. While it's located like this, that's why you can remove this bolt and position starter vertically again with connector already on. So you will be able to tighten the bolt with the ratchet, because there is no way how you can squeeze the ratchet while starter was already partially installed to tighten this electrical connector. This is the best way. When starter is standing vertically, you can tighten this connector just like that. Otherwise, you're not gonna be able to fit the ratchet inside. Tighten the bolt with the ratchet to specs. There is a problem with installing this small connector. This pin doesn't want to click on it. That's why I'm trying to rotate it a little bit. It's supposed to click and it's supposed to be well secured on a starter. Then you mount him on a upper bolt with a ground point, lower him on a lower bolt right here. You can insert the bolt just with your fingertips, but the ratchet not gonna squeeze and you will need to tighten it from the bottom. And then tighten the bolts to spare. On the top and in the bottom. On the bottom you'll need to go underneath, because there is no other way. Ratchet not gonna fit. This is this bolt, the tightening. While working under car, it's better to put safety goggles on, because all this rust probably will be falling onto your eyes. This bolt have to be tightened. Just take your time. Installation of the starter, of the new starter is done. Both lower and upper bolts are tightened to specs. Electrical connectors are connected. It's time to install the air filter box back. Actually pretty simple with the club. With the air filter box, just put it in. Make sure that you will fit this hose right here. And then we get about this electrical connector. The most important, tighten the hoses bolts, throttle body hose to specs. This is very important, because if the hose will accidentally disconnect, your engine locked up like your accelerator pedal is completely pressed, and you will be always on a maximum speed. So it's very, very important to tight them. Connect the electrical connectors. This one. This one. Connect the source which goes from PCB valve. And connect right here. After you made sure that you reconnected everything, and everything is properly secured and fitted, it's time to connect the negative terminal of the battery and start the vehicle. This was the replacement of the starter. Roshnion. Thanks for watching.